Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched Pradhan Mantri Atmanirbhar Swasth Bharat Yojana and also inaugurated various development projects worth more than 5,200 crore in Varanasi. Uttar Pradesh Governor Anandiben Patel, Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath and Union Health Minister Mansukh Mandavia also attended the inaugural function. Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated 9 medical colleges in Siddharthnagar, Uttar Pradesh. Union Home Minister Amit Shah and Jammu Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Manoj Sinha offered prayers at Khir Bhavani Temple in Srinagar. The Home Minister also met the family of slain Inspector of Jammu and Kashmir Police Parvez Ahmed in Naugam. Booked in 2 cases for allegedly disturbing communal harmony and committing order electoral offences during 2014 Lok Sabha elections, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has been granted bail by a special court. The court has fixed November 3rd as the next date of hearing in both cases. The government of Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra have issued alerts regarding a new COVID-19 variant that has been detected in people. As per the reports, the new variant is a sub-lineage of the Delta variant. 7 new cases have already been detected in Madhya Pradesh's Indore city. Vice President of India Venkaiah Naidu presented superstar Rajinikanth with the 51st Dada Saheb Phalke Award, India's highest film honour, during the 67th National Film Award ceremony. The renowned honour was given to 70-year-old for his remarkable contribution to Indian cinema. Sajid Nadiadwala got the National Award for his film Chhore, which won Best Hindi Film, and dedicated it to late actor Sushant Singh Rajput. Virat Kohli, who is leading the Indian team in his first and the last T20 World Cup, didn't have a great start as the captain, as the men in blue suffered a 10-wicket loss at the hands of their arch-rival Pakistan. The Indian fans couldn't take this hard loss as they started criticising skipper Virat Kohli for his poor captaincy and selection calls.